Well, I'm Iván Hernández-Cazorla. I'm a researcher and I work as Korea Digital with the main objective of engage to the humanities, encourage to the humanities to use the technology to spread the cultural heritage and the history of the Canary Islands. So, yes, Canary Islands are mainly known for a holiday place, and it is in Europe, politically speaking, because it is an autonomous community of Spain. But we have historical relations with Africa due to the first colonizations of the Canary Islands by the Amazigh people, or even with the slave trade or another kind of historical facts. This is a project directed by the University of Las Palmas de Gran Canaria. His name, translated in English, is Rescue and Value of African Cultural Heritage in the Canary Islands. This is a use case and is a work in progress. So when I show you the wiki, you are going to show a wiki laboratory in which I work. So we have not yet this built up in the own domain and the own hosting of the project. So about the project, the head researcher of this project is Germán Santana Pérez. He is funded mainly by the University of Las Palmas de Gran Canaria and other institutions. The main objective of this project is research the cultural heritage in the Canary Islands that is influenced by Africa or Africans. It is like, for example, a picture in which there is an African man or woman, or even with interpretations of some kind of the cultural heritage. The project itself, without the Semantic MediaWiki part, is based in collect data of these goods, of these elements. So the health researcher has walked around all the islands and checked bibliography and source about this. He also documents them photographically to improve the project and the way how we show it to the users. And then we have to describe and make recommendation for his preservation in case if it is necessary. Some of the items are well preserved, so some items has not recommendations. The project proposed at the initial stage, when I was not there yet, to create a website to manage and show the data collected. One of the main problems I have to face with this project is that the data is collected in documents in format docs. So there are fact sheets like info boxes without an structure that we can create or structure automatically. It was a very crazy thing in this sense. But I decided to propose to the head researcher to use Semantic MediaWiki over WordPress or over any other kind of CMS, because Semantic MediaWiki has capacity to manage several kind of data. Even we have the opportunity to integrate this data with some kind of specialized vocabulary, like, for example, CIDOC-CRM. I propose to the health researcher Semantic MediaWiki too, because we can have data structured and linked that offers easy queries and easy to create interface to read and contribute, so it will make easier to present the data and the elements to the people. This is a project not only for the researchers. The idea is to use it, being read by the people of the Canary Islands or outside, to learn about the cultural heritage. So it is an important question. Make easy ways to query the data and to consult them. Semantic MediaWiki with MediaWiki has a whole ecosystem of extensions to improve the interface and the usage. So we have not to create a specialized software or anything else. And there is a very great community to get help and contributors working on everything. And finally, I think all these features, all these reasons why I choose Semantic MediaWiki over another option, is the capacity to deal with the technology gap in humanities. In humanities, there is a gap with the technology very, very strong, at least here in the Canary Islands. There are formation course in some kind of technology, but there is a step back in the sense of the consideration of the importance of the linked data and the semantic web. We have uses practically a lot of compounds of Semantic MediaWiki, like, for example, page for represent the items, categories to use as collection, and keep a class, a semantic class. Then we are using concepts to make some dynamic collections to make easier to consult by the users. And we create forms to create the items. It is very important because the project is not being edited by the public, but due the technology gap, it's very important to have a form very detailed and easy to understand to the researchers create this item with the data they have. At this moment, I am creating the items to test everything, but in the future, I hope the researchers and the health researchers create these ones. In the case of the properties, we use to describe, and we are using one of the latest implementations of the Semantic MediaWiki, the schemes, because I consider them a really good tool to make strong the structure, the data model we are using. We have created a data model. We are trying to make an approach to CIDOC-CRM, but the important vocabulary is just a few properties. We are just testing it. And we have created properties, categories, forms, and templates necessary to make it work at the initial stage. And in the progress tasks list, we are thinking in the use of the identifier as the page name, and then display a customized title, because there is possibilities to have items with the same name. For example, here in the slide, I have an example, Cuadro de Animas. It is a very, very generic name. There is possibilities to have another page titled Cuadro de Animas. So I think the most useful will be to use the identifier as the title, and then display title like this part. There is the identifier and the name of the element. So this has another advantage. If we in some time of the future decide to propose this identifier, for example, for Wikidata, it would be easier to link with this wiki. We are working on browsing interface, creating concepts and ask queries that could be linked using the limit zero and the search label to query outside of the page of the element, or even embedded in the page, like, for example, the maps or the galleries. We plan to design a scheme based on Chameleon's customized layout. It is a powerful scheme that provides a lot of components, very useful, so we can create a strong scheme based on Chameleon. And the last part will be keep creating items, app, stop to collect the data with in-docs files, because having this interface, all this project, the easier process will be to collect directly on the wiki. So let's see the wiki lab. The wiki is mainly in Spanish because I'm working in Spanish to show the head researcher what I'm doing. I'm going to explain everything. It is a fast walkthrough. So this is the place in which I'm collecting all the information, the data. For example, here is the data model. We use an identifier. We use an item property and a kind of good, a kind of element. So these three properties are linked to CIDOC-CRM. If we look at them, for example, we are using the Semantic MediaWiki imported vocabulary. We import vocabulary from the CIDOC conceptual reference model. And there is a lot of properties. Maybe some of them will be changed in the near future, like this one. But this is a record composed by the postal address, the municipality, and the island. We have the coordinates to work with the maps. And then we have, at least for the moment, we have two properties to work with the files. For example, we have a description for a property to describe the image. And then we have a property to represent the to mark what item is represented by the image. This helps us to select in the queries the image. We have created different values for the identifiers, one for each island, for example, EH for El Hierro or TF for Tenerife. And it's composed by these two words, these two letters, and four digits. For the ways to read the data, we are working in concepts like for easy concepts like, for example, items in La Palma or items in Fuerteventura. The islands are Gran Canaria, Lanzarote, Fuerteventura, Tenerife, La Gomera, La Palma, and El Hierro. So these are the names of the islands. And here we use the concept parcel function in which we query to the main class, the main category, patrimonio, and then we ask for the record passing unnecessary for the two main properties and then using La Palma. This is the same case we have here. And then we have a project to insert links to these queries, like for example, all the items in Fuerteventura with recommendations to preserve them. For example, these three. Here, for example, Adoración de los Magos has a recommendation that says restore the colors of the table. These are the items created. Here is the Cuadro de Animas, for example. And I'm going to show you two different pages. This one is the testing page, so it's not a real item. The idea is to have a description here, then the recommendation, the localization of the map based on the coordinates, and the gallery with all the images that has the property represents to this item. And then we have information, additional information. And in the info box, we have the main container of the data. For example, in tipo de bien, we have an A. It is because we have not developed the typology we are going to use, but this is not going to be A, B, or C. It is going to be like, for example, religious image or building or something else. Then here we have the identifier with a note used with the parser function info and the grado dimpo. This is the level of heritage importance. Then we use this to make easier to consult the data. And if we see, for example, another one like Cuadro de Animas, we can see that if we have not an image, it warns the user that there is an image to represent this element. So we encourage them to contribute to the project. There is not a way planet yet, but I really think the users can contribute to this project with teammates or even fixing or suggesting change. This, for example, have not any error in the schemes. So we have, when we have not a data, we use a special a template to warn the user. And then, for example, if we, I want to show you someone, some item with restrictions invalidated. For example, this one, we have the entity subvalid. It is very useful for us and to and for the health researcher because we have not a description and we have no coordinates. And we have considered that these are this will be mandatory properties because an item is always located in some place, and it is always and it always should be described. The recommendation, for example, is not a mandatory property, and this scheme is based. This scheme is this one. We have here the restrictions, so it is being very useful for to validate the data. And then, for example, I saw you here some kind of maps we want to show, for example, in the landing page, showing all the items. We have here an anomaly, a problem. For example, we can check this point is in the middle of Libya. Is Libya? Yes. And I really don't know why it is there, but it is because in the documentation I'm using to create this page, the coordinate was wrong, but we have to correct this. Then, for example, we have another problem here. We have a point in the middle of the sea. Maybe if it was a ship or something else, it would have sense. But no, it is a house. In this case, it was a slave house in a sugar ingenio. An ingenio is where the sugar was collected and it was processed. Here we have the same example for Fuerteventura. If we click in them, we have some data. We decide to not use the description because in some case, like we saw in the Cuadro de Animas, the description are so long, so this tooltip could be very, very long and it is not very useful. So I think I have so I want to show you the formula, and it is the last part. If we click in edit with form, it is unstyled. The idea is to make it more beautiful and useful. But we can see here the identifier, the field for the all these are test files. Here we have a drop down. This is a test file with autocomplete based on the namespace files description. And here there is something that I like really much. Because if we select in this one, we saw on value, And it is very useful because if not, the form will be very loaded of fields and confusing. So then we have the coordinates. I decide to use this rating five field to mark the importance of the heritage, because it's more beautiful in this way to mark this. Then it is translated in a numeric value, like we see in the page. And well, I think I'm not forgetting nothing. So thank you very much for your attention. If you have any questions, it will be a pleasure to answer.
Thank you very much, Ivan. That's really interesting, and it's a great project, I think. So also one of my questions is how many people are working on this. Maybe I have missed it for some reason, but it's always a question of man and women power.
Can you repeat the question,
please? How many people are working on this project?
At this moment, is the health researcher and me.
Aha, two people.
Yes. Yes, we are two people. It is a small project. I'm working strong because I have the hope to extend this project more than 1 or 2 years, because there are a lot of cultural heritage, African cultural heritage here. So we can contribute with a lot of ways. I have seen there is some questions here.
At least Ingo is saying that in the form, it looked like a flattened CRM, so you would have to insert property pairs for RDF exports, etc.
In the form, it looks like. Oh, well, the first question, how do you handle nested structures like E52 time spannings? I don't know. I really don't know. I'm researching about it because I have been read the conceptual model. I'm trying to understand every part. I just import the vocabulary that I think I can integrate. I have to research more how to integrate the full CIDOC-CRM in this kind of project. I'm not only interested for this project, I am also interested because I have projects to present about cultural heritage wikis for each municipality to make easier to catalogue everything in the municipality, not only African, just everything, all the cultural heritage of this municipality. So I really don't know how to handle this kind of class. I'm already working on it. It is a really important question, Ingo. So thank you. And I hope to have an answer soon. I'm really not, I'm historian, and I really, really like ontologies and the technology that is my passion, complemented by the history. But ontology is something I'm really interested, but I have to read a lot to make part of me. What is the platform used? It is Linux with i3 desktop. It is Debian, and I don't know if it is more questions. Okay.
So last questions, because we stick a bit on the schedule, because we try to bring Jan's presentation if you have a chance to do so. There is a what conversation tools have you used? E docx or wikitext? Not conversation, a conversion tool. Sorry, of course, conversion. Conversation is something different.
What? I'm sorry, I'm reading the answer of Ingo.
Pretty complicated. Okay, maybe you can look or discuss this now in the chat furthermore, and I think there are just one or two questions.
I think there is no what conversion tool have you used, Docs? No, no conversion tools. Sorry. I do the size of the information given. I prefer to make it manually. It is faster, in my opinion. There is not a lot of elements with information yet. There is 559, I think, no more, because due to the COVID, the travel to the islands have practically very slow, so the head researcher is not documenting as fast as it would be possible. Yes, I know Pandoc, but at this moment the efforts to implement it or to use it, I think it is faster and better to make just this conversion to the pay form. And then it is important too, because there is not the same model in the documentation of the health researcher than in the wiki. So I have to filter some kind of data and have it in some specific files.